Hi and welcome to The Winning Factor. I'm Alan Aitken and on this show each week we try and identify a key element of an upcoming race in Hong Kong, one that we might look back on afterwards as having led us down the path to the winner. We're racing on Easter Monday this week at Sha Tin and the first race we're going to have a look at is on the dirt. It's race 7 and our winning factor, the weights. Now a glance at the field here and we see that this class 2 features some of our better performing dirt trainers, Gunnison from the John Size Yard, Ugly Warrior for Me Choi, and John Moore trained Fortune Booth. And just along those lines, I'm going to show you a graphic now. This is over the last 10 years in Hong Kong on the dirt, and these are the leading 6 jockeys and trainers. Now you can take your pick how you assess them. Me Choi wins more races than John Size and John Moore, but they have better strike rates than him. On the jockeys table, it's Zach Purton and Joe Marrera up the top, and pretty much the same story. One has the better strike rate, one has more winners over that 10 years. Of course, Joe only rode here since 2013. But they're our top performers on the dirt, and that leads us into 2 of the main chances here in Monday's Dirt Class 2. First of all, Gunnison, John Size and Joe Marrera, and also Ugly Warrior, which is a ride for Zach Purton for the Me Choi Yard. And we have a direct form line between these two horses in a race that was won by another of their rivals on Monday, Big Time Baby. We go back to race 225. And on this occasion, Ugly Warrior was expected to win by punters. He was sent out a very short price favourite, odds on in fact. And he looked to have his chance. He finished in third placing and was just nutted on the line or near the line by Gunnison for the second placing there behind the convincing winner, Big Time Baby. After that, Choi moved Ugly Warrior across to the turf where he hasn't been disgraced, but he hasn't been quite as good, while Gunnison had another run on the dirt. And as we see in this video, he was an impressive winner on this occasion, barreling away to win by a wide margin. And that's been a crucial element in how they line up on Monday. That easy win meant that Gunnison soared in the ratings, going up 11 points, while Ugly Warrior through those turf races has come down a point. So they actually meet 12 points Ugly Warrior's way for that half length between them back in December. And that looks a crucial element of the race. And on the map, any element that provides a difference between them is important because it looks here like they're going to race pretty much in the same spot together. So one that anything that gives one an advantage over the other is going to be important. We'll see Jumbo Luck probably lead coming across them from the outside, and then Gunnison and Ugly Warrior position up just behind him. So the tip in race 7, Ugly Warrior. His winning factor, the weights. As you can see, both have great chances, they have good personnel, and they look to get good runs in the race. But I think that swing in the handicaps is going to prove the crucial element to this race. The second race we're going to have a look at on Monday is race 10. And our winning factor here, the map. Now taking a look at this field, your eye is drawn to the last start winner Superwise over this course and distance, as well as the 3-year-olds. Perfect Match, Shining Gem, and Chairman Low. And the pair we're going to look at most closely here is Perfect Match and Chairman Low. Now we're going to have a look at Chairman Low's latest effort in race 545, and he hasn't earned himself a lot of brownie points lately for being a beaten favourite several times. On this occasion, he got a long way back out of the race, he fluffed the start, and left himself with way too much to do on the home turn. But you'll see he unleashed a very strong sprint. He just wasn't able to sustain it all the way down the home straight at Sha Tin. Now, the last time we saw Perfect Match, he was also a beaten favourite back in race 375. And on this occasion, he crossed from an outside gate. He sat outside the lead, but he found King Opie just too strong. And of course, that's no disgrace. King Opie, winner of 4 or 5 races this season, he's been in fantastic form, and he just wore Perfect Match down over the final stages. Now, while Chairman Low has been seen at the races frequently of late, that isn't the case with Perfect Match. He'd won 3 in a row before that defeat, And then Danny Shum made a crucial decision to give him a break, including some time up at the Chung Fa Training Centre. And that looks to have been a key point in the development of this impressive young horse. We saw him in a barrier trial recently. In fact, he's had three trials leading up to this race. But the latest on April 6 at Happy Valley, a very impressive winner. He was able to, again, sit outside the lead. He didn't beat an awful lot, but it was the way he did it. Zach Purton just sitting still on him, not asking him for any effort at all, and he still came away to win very, very easily. And paradoxically, when we look at the map, Barrier 14 might even be a benefit to him rather than a disadvantage. Now, you have a look at the map here, and he's drawn the outside, and we know how he's going to race. He's going to bounce out and press forward, but the advantage here of Gate 14 is that Zach Purton is able to look across to his inside, see how the race is working out, and make a decision to either go all the way forward or maybe to tuck in behind one or two if the pace is a bit stronger than expected. So he is able to plot his own course, so to speak. Chairman Lowe, as we saw last time, he messed up the start. At times he's been forward, other times he's been back. He's a little bit all over the place with his tactical pattern. So I think that gives Perfect Match some sort of advantage. So in race 10, the tip, Perfect Match. His winning factor, the map. That trial shows us that Perfect Match has come back in great order after his little off-season break. And the Gate 14, I don't think is a disadvantage. I think it enables Zach Purton to pick the tactics that best suit his horse. Well, that's it from the winning factor this week. Good luck on Monday. We'll see you next time.